Okay, so I just want to start the introduction about myself. My name is Ram Boyapati. I have around 13 years of experience in IT industry. And these 13 years of experience, I've been working for the SQL Server, MSBA Technology, and the Power BI Data Analyst, and Azure Data Engineering. So these are the technologies what I've been working for last 13 years. And in this 7 years of experience, I have a training experience over here. From last 7 years, I've been in this IT trainings and placements also we are doing. I have started this eClasses.com. So this is our website where you can find all the courses what we are offering and everything, eClasses.com. We are located in Hyderabad, Amirpet location. We are conducting online and offline classes as well. So classroom training and online also we are going to offer. We have our own LMS portal. We are teaching our sessions in the LMS portals, and we are providing access to the students of the class videos and doubts clarifications, everything from the LMS portal only. Okay, so and also we have our own mobile app as well, so everyone can able to download our mobile app also. Okay, so to download the mobile app and to sign into our LMS portal, so this is the link you can able to use. So I'm requesting all of you, please download our mobile app and you can able to log into our LMS portal as well. Okay, so now in my 7 years of experience, most of the people who are joining to learn this Azure Data Engineering course, Azure Data Engineering course, the people who are coming to learn this Azure Data Engineering course, mostly they are having a different kind of background people. So the minimum qualification to join this course and learn, they should have at least a graduation. The graduation in a BTech or BSc, BCom, or any civil, mechanical, any kind of background. If they have at least any graduation, BBA or BCA, whatever, or any post graduation, MBA, MCA, or MSc, anything. And also, the people are mostly belongs to the passed out, their passed out year of the graduation or post graduation, mostly in between 2010 to 2022. It might be 2005 also. Okay? It might be 2005 also. So whatever it is, they are belongs to some passed out year long back, in between this passed out year range. So the first category of the people, once their graduation or post graduation completed, they are immediately joining to your IT job as a fresher. Let's for example take one use case. One student is completed his engineering in 2013, immediately joined in a company as a IT job fresher, and is working currently java.net testing, whatever it is. So far he got some experience like a 10 years or 15 years or 7 years or 6 years or 3 years or 4 years, he gained some experience on the technology. But unfortunately the technology whatever he was working, it is not having demand in the market, right? So that is the reason he is going to increasing of his salary. He wants to secure his job. He is looking for a demanding technology in the market. So what is the demanding technology in the market currently? It's going to be a Azure Data Engineering. So when he is learning this Azure Data Engineering course with his experience already in IT, when he is going to join a new job, he is going to join on the Azure Data Engineering course, is he going to apply for the jobs on a fresher? No. Definitely he is going to keep experience on this Azure Data Engineering, 2 to 4 years of experience. If he has a 10 years of experience, out of 10 years, he is going to tell in his resume, last 4 years I've been working as Azure Data Engineer. Earlier I have 6 years of experience on java.net or whatever the testing. So definitely this category person, he is already having some experience in IT. After learning this course, he is going to apply a jobs for a experienced person. The second one, he is a passed out same 2010-2022, but he joined in a non-IT company. Instead of for a IT job, he is going to work like a non-IT job over here. So at the time after completion of the BTech or BCom or BCA, any graduation, any post graduation, he is going to join like a US recruiter job, customer care executive, accountant, Google Maps engineer, network admin, teacher, faculty, civil engineer, mechanical, manufacturing. So that person belongs to anything. That person belongs to anything over here. So he gained some experience of around 2 years or 3 years or 4 years or up to 10 years in non-IT experience. The first category people having IT experience, second category people having non-IT experience. But now they realized, because even if they are working 10 years in non-IT technologies, they have up to 7 lakhs only maximum packages. So now they want to switch their career into IT. So they are looking for a demanding technology in the market to learn. After learning this Azure Data Engineering course, with their previous experience, whichever they are having a non-IT experience, are they going to apply for the jobs like a fresher? No. They are going to apply for the jobs like a 2 to 4 years of experience on this Azure Data Engineering course. So in this technology, like when they are going to apply, definitely they have to keep the experience. So that experience, whatever they have already in the non-IT, that they can turn into IT experience. And the third category, they are just passed out in between this date range, year range, but they were not doing any job. They don't have any work experience. They are just doing a business or preparing for a government exam, civils, groups, banks, and they have some career gap. So now they want to come to IT industry. They are going to learn Azure Data Engineering course, and it's going to be 2 to 5 years of experience. They are going to apply for the positions. So this is how most of the people are having different kind of backgrounds when they want to come to this learning of this Azure Data Engineering course. The final category is the freshers. Freshers means they have just completed their graduation in 2023 and 24. They don't have any experience or career gap. So they are just like a trained freshers. Some companies, they are looking for this kind of people as well. Some companies, they are looking this kind of people as well. Okay. So I hope whoever joined in this demo session definitely belongs to any of one category. I just want to check how many belongs to category 1, how many belongs to category 2, category 3, category 4. Just ping me if you belongs to category 1, say number 1. If you belongs to 2, 3, 4. So can you ping me the number? Your profile is matching to which one? Can all of you ping me? 1. Okay. 1. 1. 2. 2. 1. 1. 1. 1. 3. 1. 3. Give me all of you. Okay, so I have identified one more category here. Some people work for IT, but then after they have some gap. Few more category, some people work for non-IT, but now they have some career gap. Okay, right. Oh, someone belongs to none of the above. Okay, no problem. We will understand that profile later. Okay, I will talk with one-on-one, like whoever having needed a career counseling later as well. Okay, so mostly what I have observed over here, so most of the students belonging to which category? Most of the people are belongs to what I have observed, mostly 1, 2, 3. So all the students definitely belong to this category. Category 1, I can see there are 60%. 40% of the students are belongs to category 1. Then after category 2, I can see there is a 30%. Then equally the category 3 also we have 30%. So this is how we have a student wants to come from IT to same demanding technology. Earlier they work for a different technology and they want to move to non-IT to IT job. They have some career gap. Now they want to move to IT job. So for all these people, whoever completed their graduation and they want to come to IT industry after a long gap, after a experience, definitely they are going to apply for the jobs like a experienced person. You are not going to apply for the jobs as a fresher. So definitely we are going to apply for the jobs as an experienced person. So how much experience you are going to showcase on this particular Azure Data Engineering technology, definitely you are going to keep 2 to 4 or 5 maximum. Okay, let's take one example. For example, one of the student worked for 10 years on the IT and he was working for Java. So when he is going to applying for the Azure Data Engineering jobs after completion of this course, how he is going to make his experience? He is going to make the 6 years of Java experience earlier, and from last 4 years he is going to get Azure Data Engineering kind of experience. Another example, 10 years of non-IT experience, and how he is going to split that experience? The previous starting 6 years non-IT and the current 4 years he is going to work on the Azure Data Engineering. He is going to work on the Azure Data Engineering. Now this 3 to 4 years of Azure Data Engineering experience he is going to keep. He don't have any experience. Okay, right. Freshers are simply applying for a trained fresher jobs on Azure Data Engineering, because some companies are asking, startup companies, anybody completed the trained fresher jobs, they are going to apply for the jobs. But most of the scenarios, the category 1, category 2, category 3 people, are they are going to applying for the jobs as a experienced jobs only. Correct? When you are going to apply like a experienced job 2 to 4 years, then definitely the expectations on the interview is very high. Correct? And also the work expectations. When you are joining to your company, so they are taking into your project and you need to work like a 2 to 4 years of experience guy. So what I am thinking here, without taking any proxy interviews, without taking anyone work support, how can you get a job? How can you work without taking anyone help? How can you crack your interview yourself without taking anyone help? Without taking anyone help of the work support, how can you crack the interview? So in my 7 years of experience, when I have observed many students, why they got failed not to get the job? Because out of 100 students, only 10 students are getting the jobs. Why? Because they are just completing a normal regular trainings. So this normal regular trainings is offered by every institution. If you go to any training institute, they are offering this Azure Data Engineering course. It's like a 2 months of the course they are going to offer. Daily 1 hour session, it's going to be Monday to Friday. So whatever the Azure Data Engineering regular training offered by every institution, 2 months daily, 1 hour, Monday to Friday, after completion of this course, are you in a position to crack the interview yourself? Are you in a position to work on the real-time projects yourself without taking anyone help? Only 10% of the people only. Out of 100, only 10% of the people only able to crack the interviews, able to crack work on the real-time projects without taking anyone help. Why? Because they are just completing only program 1. What is this program 1? It's a simple Azure Data Engineering training. I want to make this 10 into 90. How can I do? So I'm going to introduce two programs. One is about a program 1. In the program 1, so as usual, the Azure Data Engineering regular training, it's going to be 60 hours duration. It's going to be Monday to Friday, daily 1 hour. It's a live interactive sessions, daily class recordings we are going to provide, and daily class notes we are going to share with you. And in any institution, after the course, after the class completion, 1 hour class completion, then if you are getting any doubts while you are going to practice, you may not have a support. For example, you might be in a online, you are from Bangalore, Hyderabad or Chennai, somewhere. When you are practicing in your from your home, how did you get the support for the issue resolution and doubts clarification? We have our own mobile app. Inside that mobile app, whenever you are getting any doubts, immediately you can able to reach out our team. You can directly ping to me. I will clarify your doubts whenever you are going to learn this course over here. Whenever you are going to learn this course, I will directly clarifying to you from our mobile app. Okay. So this is the program one. It's a regular Azure data engineering training. 2 months we are going to cover. Inside this program one, what are all the things we are going to cover? What is the course content we are going to cover inside? So inside this Azure data engineering, we are going to cover this like the main ETL services, data factory. It's a zero coding. No need to write any coding. Databricks. It's not a coding. You are just writing a commands of SQL or PySpark. So any of one you can write down. Either you can write down SQL or PySpark. Is it a Python? Many people were asking, sir, this Azure Data Engineering is a coding or non-coding? It is not a non-coding. It is not a coding. Only in these many services, when you are going to learn, only within this Databricks, when you are using, you are writing a few commands related to SQL or PySpark. Is the PySpark means it is a Python? No. It's on top of the Python, they developed another commands, that is PySpark. Let's, for example, in Python, if you're writing 10 lines of the code, but inside, in the PySpark, one command is enough to achieve that. It's very, very easy to learn. Okay. So I am going to discuss in this training these many services. Out of these services, only within this Databricks only we are writing some commands. Just imagine how much percentage of this course is a coding. It's very like a 10% only, right? Nowadays, without writing any commands, there is no technology to learn. So then you can decide whether this is a coding or non-coding. Okay. So Data Factory is a ETL tool. It's going to be used zero coding. No need to write even single command. Databricks is a where you are going to write down some commands either related to SQL or PySpark. Next, live streaming data. If you want to stream the live data, you can able to use this one. And next, Azure Synapse Analytics. This is a combination of Data Factory and Databricks. If you are learning Data Factory, Databricks, you no need to learn separately Azure Synapse Analytics. These are the most of the services I'm going to discuss in this training as a part of the ETL. Now, if you want to do the storing of the data, I'm going to discussing about storage account and blob storage, data lake, Azure SQL database, Synapse dedicated SQL pool. These are the services I'm going to use for storing of the data in a storage services over here. Apart from this Azure data engineering services, I'm going to discuss related to admin related services as well, like key vaults, logic caps, Active Directory, Azure functions, Azure DevOps CI/CD pipelines, and also at the end I'm going to take few sessions for the Power BI as well. These we are using for the deployment of your project. These we are using for the security and access related things we are going to discuss. I'm going to discuss how to design some reports by using a Power BI as well. So after completion of this part, after completion of this course content in this schedule, okay, in this schedule, how we are going to do? We are going to only 10% of the students are getting the job. Because this is everywhere. This is shared by every institution, and every institution is offering for you this program one. But only unique things inside this program one comparing to other institutions is we have a mostly chat support for the doubts clarification, and we are covering more the services course content comparing to the other institutions. But apart from this, why our students, 90% of the students are getting the jobs by cracking their interviews themselves and working in the real-time projects? The reason, because parallelly we are going to conduct program two. Program one, the Azure Data Engineering regular training, we are conducting in the Monday to Friday. But where you coming to the program two, we are going to conduct this program two. It's a real-time program. It's a real-time program. What is the main vision of this real-time program? The main vision of this real-time program is I want you to make more perfect to crack the interview yourself, because you are going to apply for the jobs 2 to 4 years of experience. I want you to work on the real-time projects because you have to apply for the jobs 2 to 4 years of experience. So to achieve these two things, definitely you have to enroll for this program two as well. If you are completing this program one and program two, definitely you are in a position to crack the interviews yourself and work in the real-time projects without taking any work supports. Okay, what are the key highlights of this program two? So in this real-time program, it's going to be offered on the weekends, Saturdays and Sundays. So what exactly this real-time program? You know, when you are joining to any company, how they are implementing the projects in real time. In the real time, when a project is implementing, they are following a methodology, agile methodology. The same way, we were creating a agile methodology with a sprint model. Each sprint contains tasks. So there are 10 to 15 sprints we are going to run, and in each sprint we have around 10 to 15 tasks we are going to give with the real-time scenarios. With a real-time kind of scenarios, we are going to give you this sprints, each sprint wise some task, real-time based tasks. So from Monday to Friday, you have to finish all the tasks, whatever the sprint I am giving. So one sprint, 1 week you need to work. On the Saturday, we are going to connect with you. You need to share your screen and you need to perform the reviewing of all the tasks. Whatever the task, sprint one you have completed, right? You need to share your screen and you need to do all the tasks in front of me. On the Sunday, we are going to discuss about the doubts clarification and real-time use cases in the implementation point of view and real-world projects and all those things we are going to discuss on the Sunday. So Saturday, Sunday in this real-time program, we are completely focusing on the real-time apart from the training. And also we are conducting some mock interviews as well. And we are implementing you with you one end-to-end project as well. Finally, we are going to prepare a resume for you and any kind of references, email addresses for applying the job also we are going to provide you. These are the key highlights of the program too. So let me show you that sprint two model. So whatever the things we are covering inside the training, apart from that training, we are making you more perfection with a few more tasks we are applying over here. You can see, you just imagine, these are all the tasks. This is the sprint one, sprint two, sprint three, sprint four. This is how these many scenario based things you need to perform in your project over here. Almost 143 scenarios apart from the training. See, these many scenarios I'm going to make you to work on this. When you are working on these many scenarios, definitely you will get more than 5 years of experience knowledge. So every day the student has to update the status, how many tasks completed, which task completed, which is possible, which is not possible. A lot of discussion is going to happen on Saturday, Sundays. These are the students, how many tasks they have completed, not completed, all the things you can able to understand it over here. This is how we are going to make you more perfect in the task wise different kind of scenarios. It just when you are going to joining to other institution, just ask few scenarios your trainer whether he is going to cover that scenarios or not. Okay, so if he is covering those scenarios, yes, definitely you can join, because Every institution, they are going to keep what are all the content they are going to cover. They will keep a lot of headings, data factory, Databricks, streaming analytics, Synopsy, many things they will keep. But data factory, some people will teach 10 hours, some people will teach 20 hours, some people will teach 30 hours, some people teach 5 hours also. Some people will teach 20 scenarios, 30 scenarios, 15 scenarios, 5 scenarios. You don't know until you are paying the fees how many scenarios they are going to cover. But I am promising you to make all this to be work by yourself. I want you to make perfect on all these scenarios over here. Okay? So you just ask your trainer when he is going to join to a organization. I mean, when you are going to joining with his to work on this one, ask this scenarios whether he is going to cover or not. So let me give you one scenario whether he is able to cover this or not. So the scenario is, let's for example, how to maintain the version control of the notebook in the Azure DevOps Git repository. Okay, and also you can ask how to monitor and see log analytics of the job schedule of the data factory pipelines and Databricks notebooks. And also you can ask one more scenario, how to run a notebooks without using data factory Databricks. Are they going to cover these scenarios or not? Just ask them. If they are able to cover, yes, go ahead with him. Okay, because they are just like a regular patterns. Most of the institutions I have seen, they are covering regular patterns, regular basic scenarios only they are covering. But we are going in a next level, and covering a scenarios means like from not only from my end, I want you to make perfect in each one, hands on. Because the program 2 concept is, I want every student to be focused on the training. So that is the reason I have started this program and program 2 parallelly. So the program 1 is Azure Data Engineering regular training, 60 hours duration, 1 hour daily, Monday to Friday. The cost we are charging for this program 1 is 20,000. Some institutions are taking only for this one 25,000. Some institutions are taking 19,000. So parallelly we are starting the program too. It's a real-time program. This is going to be 30 hours Saturday, Sundays, and 2 hours per day. It's going to be 15,000. Program one is 20,000. Program two is 15,000. Almost we are going to cover 100 hours of the course. 100 hours of the course, program one and program two. So both the charges will be 35,000. But we are giving offer program one plus program two. Both we are going to give you 25,000. If you are enrolling for the two programs, we are giving you offer 25,000. So this entire program one and program two parallelly we are going to conduct. So it's going to be 2 to 3 months of the duration to complete the entire course over here. If you have any doubts on this one, to speak with course curriculum, course content, and anything, you just reach out this number 7997457288. She will take care of everything, all the details. Okay, to learn this Azure Data Engineering course, do we need any prerequisites to learn first and then I need to start the Azure Data Engineering? No, there is nothing prerequisite for Azure Data Engineering. Okay, but when the people, some people or any people, my recommendation, when you want to come to IT industry, when you want to come to IT industry, if you have some basics of the SQL, MS SQL basics, okay, or if you have some basics of the Python, if you have some basic idea about these two, you can learn 30 courses in IT industry. 30 courses. If you are learning these two, on top of these two courses, there are 30 courses you can able to complete with the 20 to 30% of the effort only. So for every student whoever is coming to our institution, first we will recommend to learn these basic courses. So that is the reason we are offering for every student MS SQL developer course, 20 hours live classes. 20 hours live classes, we are just charging, actual cost is 7,000, but we are charging for 299 rupees only. Python for data engineering or data analysis we are teaching. It's going to be 25 hours live classes, classroom and online. This is going to be charged 7,000, but we were charging only 599 rupees only. These two courses we are offering separately. If anybody interested to learn MS SQL or Python, just for 299 rupees and 599 rupees, it's your wish. If you want to join these two separately, you can. But anyhow, in Azure Data Engineering course, whatever the commands you required related to SQL, related to PySpark, I'm going to teach inside that one. But if you want to get a full confidence on these courses, just for 599 and 299, you can enroll these two courses as well. Okay, so after completion of this Azure Data Engineering course, do I need to do any kind of certification? Yes, from our institution, we are providing one certificate, but if you want any global certificate, the exam you need to write down from the Microsoft is DP203. DP203. So coming to the market of this Azure Data Engineering, how the demand and the job market, and how much package they are going to offer. So last 1.5 year, everyone knows it is a IT recession is going on. But even in this recession period also, our Azure Data Engineering course is very good demand. Daily 2 to 3 calls, interview schedules are happening. It's really a wonder. And one observation, the many students who are joining from US, Australia, UK, what I have observed, most of the people laid off because of the recession, immediately they are learning Azure Data Engineering course only. Immediately they are learning Azure Data Engineering course because of the high demand, high paid job over here. Daily we are getting 2 to 3 calls over here. Comparing to other technologies, Azure Data Engineering having very good demand in the market. Okay, how much packages they are offering with this Azure Data Engineering? If you have a 3 to 4 years of experience, if you are putting, they are offering up to 15 lakhs. Recently, one of my student, he has a 7 years of experience in other technology in IT, and earlier his package is 20 lakhs. Now he got 31 lakhs over here. Earlier his package is 20 lakhs. Now he got 30 lakhs package. 30 lakhs package. Okay, so this is all about our course, our clear roadmap, what we are going to discuss and how make you confident on this course, because many people are paying the fees and they are dropping out in between. The reason, because there is no clear roadmap by the mentor. If there is a clear roadmap from end to end how to get the job, definitely no one will drop out, right? Because no one wants to pay amount free, right? So definitely everyone should come to learn the course with more interest and to get the job. But only the people, many people drop out in the sessions is the reason, because there is no much support from the institution or from the mentor. There is no much interactivity. But here, everyone can interact with me directly. So in other institutions, that might be owner is different and trainer is different. But here, I'm the owner, I'm the trainer for this e-classes. So I'm taking care of every student, what they are doing and what kind of services we need over here. Okay, right. So nowadays in the market, there are people are a bit confusing which course I need to learn. Do I need to learn Azure Data Engineering or any DevOps courses or any Salesforce or testing or Java? There are different kind of technologies available in the market. They are a little bit of confusing what course I need to learn. My suggestion would be go the data side. So nowadays data is very, very important and it has very high demand in the market for the data. Am I right? Data is very, very high demand in the market. Nowadays we have lot of importance for the data that everyone knows. If you don't have a data, then you can't do anything in a day. So when you are coming to the data side, in IT industry, what are the jobs available? One is a data engineering job, another one is a data analyst job, Another one is a data scientist job. So which course I need to learn? Data engineering course, data analyst or data scientist? Okay. Most of the people are doing a mistake. They are directly learning the data science course. If you are learning 3 to 6 months of the course, you will not become a data scientist. Scientist means it's a lot of years of experience. When you want to come to IT, you need to start with your career somewhere in the data engineer or a data analyst or a data scientist, and then after some artificial intelligence. Nowadays it is coming AI, generative AI. So you need to grow step by step. You can't directly learn generative AI. You can't directly learn data scientist. Your career should start with a data engineering, data analyst, scientist, generative AI, because these are all interrelated, step by step. Interrelated. You can't directly go over here. You can't directly go over here. So first, let's start with the data engineering part or data analyst part. So what is data engineering part and what is a data analyst part? What these two people are going to do it over here? So data engineering means, let's for example, I will take a use case. The use case is, I have a ATM centers. Citibank is operating their ATM centers in India and USA. This is India. This is USA. This is India and this is USA. And this is like a, when there is a ATM centers, in every ATM centers, there are some ATM machines are there. As a customer, when they are going to do the transactions, every transaction data will come and store in the backend database servers. Every customer, when withdrawing some amount in the ATM centers, the transaction details will come and store in the backend database servers. Let's take another example, supermarket. When you are going to supermarket, inside the supermarket, what will happen? Inside the supermarket, it's going to be a billing counter. Every customer will buy a product and doing the transaction. So immediately the transaction details will be saved in the backend database. Any business, if you go, this is the same criteria. Same business setup will be there. Now, I'm the business owner. Definitely, I want to understand about some insights. Understanding about my business performance. How can you understand? I want to understand, hey, what is the total sales today? Total sales. Store-wise sales. Top 10 products. Top 10 products in the sales. Bottom 10 products. Bottom 10 products in the sales. So this is how I want to understand some key insights about my business. Why you need this information? I need this information to understand very clearly about my business over here. According to this information only, I can take more decisions. I can take more decisions. So how can you make this information to your business users, business owners? So now whatever the data is in a different locations, first we need to move that data into one place. Whatever the business data you have in different locations, right? You need to move that data into one particular location. How? By using some ETL tools. What do you mean by ETL? Extracting the business data from different sources and applying the transformations and finally loading of the data over here. ETL stands for extraction, transformation, and loading of the data over here. So to do this ETL process, currently what are all the services we are going to use inside in the Azure? To do this ETL process, we are going to use Data Factory and we are going to use Databricks, Live Streaming Analytics, Synapse Analytics. By using these four tools based on the scenario, any of the tool we can use to do the ETL process. What do you mean by ETL? ETL stands for extracting the data from different source systems, and then we are going to move this data into one particular place. So as a data engineer, what you need to do is, as a data engineer, you need to develop a data pipelines. Pipelines means data movement. ETL pipelines you need to design by using some ETL services. And finally, you need to store the data into one place. So to do this services, you definitely need a ETL services and you need a storage services, right? These services, where you are going to store, these services we are going to store in one particular place, that is, we are going to store this in one particular place in a cloud. So which cloud you are going to use? Microsoft Azure cloud. Microsoft Azure is a cloud environment. It is offering many services for you, and you can able to use the services. Let me try to log into the Azure portal. So where we are going to implement this Microsoft Azure portal. So portal.azure.com, you can able to log in. Inside there are so many services available. So whichever the services you needed based on your requirement, you can able to do it over here. So there are so many services here you can able to see all the services. Whichever the service you want, you can able to find out that service. These many services Microsoft Azure is offering. But as a data engineer, what are the service you need? Let's, for example, you need a data factory. See, there is a data factory. So when you want a data factory, you can simply able to use the data factory services, and then you can able to design the reports over here. Sorry, you can able to design the ETL pipelines and implement your project. If you want SQL database, see here, there is SQL. There is a storage account to store your data. So whatever the services you needed, use that services and then implement this data engineering project over here. So a data engineer role is simply is going to processing of the data in the backend by using the ETL services, and is going to store the data in a cloud environment by using some storage services. As a data engineer, mostly we are going to discuss these things. Under the storage, we have storage account, data lake. These two we are using to store your data in terms of a files. For example, when you have a Excel, CSV, text, image, audio, video files, we will use to store that inside these services. When your data is in a terms of a database and tables, you can use this one. So data engineering role is, he is going to extracting the data and transforming and loading by using this ETL services. And where he is going to store the data in these services. Finally, what he is going to do, he is going to designing of the Power BI reports over here. So who will design the Power BI reports? Power BI reports is going to be designed by the person, whoever is going to taking the data from this place into Power BI reporting tool. He is a data analyst. Data engineer is going to develop the ETL pipelines. Data analyst is going to designing of the reports by using a Power BI tool. So data engineer role is this one. Data engineer is going to processing the data. Data analyst role is designing of the reports. So designing the reports visualizations by using Power BI, it's a front end. And designing of the data pipelines to process the data in the back end is a data engineer. So this is a data engineer. This is a data analyst over here. This is a data analyst over here. All right. So this is how we can able to implement these roles. In this course, I'm going to focus mainly on the data engineering part. Data analyst Power BI, I will take few to 3 to 4 sessions to designing of the reports and dashboards over here. Okay. This is going to be 2 to 3 months of the course we are going to conducting over here. In the next session, I'm going to discussing about what are the basics of the cloud concepts. What is a cloud computing? What are the different cloud categories of the services? And what are the different kind of deployment modes? And how to create a login to this portal? Definitely, you are going to practicing inside this, right? You are going to implement. So for this, we need a free subscription license is required. How to create a free license subscription? How to implement the services? And all those things we are going to implement in the next session. So our regular sessions are going to be start from Monday onwards. We are going to start the regular sessions on Monday, and what is the timing and everything, our team is going to share all the details for you. So Monday also you can use the same meeting link whichever you have used today, right? The same meeting link you can use to join the session. And if anybody wants to speak with me personally, so simply you can call to this number 7997457228. So please call to this number and she will arrange a call after 12:30. After 12:30 only you can reach out to discuss about your career, anything personally, and call on this number. Okay, so I hope all of you has filled your form as well. If anybody not yet filled the form, please fill that form again. So let me share that form. If anybody not fill, so please can all of you please fill this form? Whoever not filled it, please fill this form. Now if you guys have any questions, meanwhile you can ask. Few people joined a little bit late. We will share the recording video of this one for everyone to your email address. You will receive one email. You will receive one email for the recording video. So according to your feasible timings only, we are going to schedule the training. Okay, so what is the most preferable timing? Can all of you please send a message? What is your most feasible time for this training, regular training? Can you tell me in the morning timings, what is the best time for all of you? Just say rough time, then according to that we can. Can all of you ping me the timings? 7 or 8 or 9, what exactly you are expecting, then according to that we can segregate it. Can all of you ping me in the chat? See, if you're missing any session, every day we are sharing the class recording video. You don't require any SSIS knowledge here to work on this data engineering. Yeah, go ahead the question. And meanwhile, others, please bring me your feasible time. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. So one question I have from the learning perspective, when you learn Microsoft technologies, it's easy to learn.
Yes.
Okay. Coming from the adoption perspective, like let's say Fortune 500 or large companies, so there is some kind of a they look for standards, open source, that kind of a thing, right? Like where the Azure will be used, Azure data engineering is used more, and where the other things like Snowflake, Informatica, Tableau, or even Hadoop, so where these are used.
So like whatever the technologies you told, Tableau, Informatica, Hadoop, and one more, Snowflake. If you see, all these services, whatever you told, are different companies. So there is no like, these are not belongs to one particular organization. And they don't have an end-to-end solution. If you take Snowflake, it is a kind of a data warehousing storage purpose. And you can little bit implement ETL process, but not that much ETL process capabilities. Where you're coming to the Tableau, it is a different company only for visualization. Again, Informatica, it is a legacy ETL tool. And when you are coming to this, the other one, what it is like, yeah. These are all things if you observe, are from different organizations. But when you are coming to the Azure is a platform where you can build any kind of solutions. It is from Microsoft. They are offering all the end-to-end services with the very minimal prices comparing to Informatica. Comparing to Informatica, the licensing, I mean, the usage cost also for Microsoft is a little bit less. Comparing to Tableau reporting tool, the competitor, my Power BI from Microsoft, the cost is less comparing to Tableau as well. So definitely the companies are looking at end-to-end solution support, whoever is providing the end-to-end business intelligence systems nowadays. So that is the reason comparing, yes, the same kind of setup we have in AWS, Google, GCP also. But even though when you are comparing to those two, Microsoft Azure data engineering usage is increasing day by day from the customers.
So from the conceptual purpose, I think Hadoop is something that provides the base conceptual things. So do we, in order to understand the data engineering world, do we need to understand the Hadoop as a?
Yeah, Hadoop is something like a legacy system we have. See, when you see inside this Microsoft Azure also, let's take one of the service, data engineering, data lake service, okay? So the data lake service is like, they have implemented the latest capabilities of the Hadoop only. If you see the behind the data lake, it has the capability of the Hadoop only. In Hadoop, there are two things, HDFS and MapReduce. Data lake is exact HDFS only, but it's more customizable. Sorry, it's more like they have designed a GUI, graphical user interface. Earlier days in Hadoop, we are writing a lot of programming in the MapReduce. But now in place of that, Hadoop, there is a Spark is coming. So in place of Spark, there is a Databricks is coming. So the Hadoop functionality is available in this Azure Data Engineering also. But you can't see directly that whether it is a Hadoop functionality or not, but definitely the storage and processing purpose, they have implemented the new services with more easy to use by using the existing behind the Hadoop ecosystem only.
One more question, let's say I have been seeing that if we are migrating from DB2 to MongoDB, so basically there we have to have some process which will do this, okay? But people are using the Spring Batch and they are trying to do this, okay? So is it because of the ignorance of the data engineering or ETL or data science, or is it how should we see this?
No, see, we can do the same thing by using this one also, okay? It's the same, whatever the task you want to do, like for example, whatever the project you want to implement, there might be some little bit of pitfalls in every technology and everywhere, and user preferences might be different and pricing point of view, and their requirement they might achieve by then well-known. For example, I am a consulting company, when I am going to recommend to the customer, these are the tools we can implement. So based on my resource and everything, there are a lot of factors will be work when they are choosing. But 90% most of the tools are supporting to fulfill the customer requirement. The other 10% why they are recommending other tools is might be resource availability, are very minor performance point of view, whatever it is. There are so many reasons are involved on that one. But whatever the requirement you told, right, that we can able to achieve by using this Microsoft data engineering as well.
Also, most of the customer data, are they ready to move it to the cloud?
Yeah, 100%. There are so many reasons for this one. Might be they want to reduce the maintenance cost and they want to maintain a lot of redundancy, they want to make a backup kind of thing, and they don't want to ready to take any risk on this one. Apart from the security concerns, few companies, few customers, most of the people, the data is in everywhere cloud. The best example for this, you and me only. Earlier days, where we are storing all our data, our photos or anything, we are storing in a pen drive or somewhere in our local memory card, right? But now where we are storing? We are storing everything in Google Drive. We are storing in the Google Photos. Everything is cloud only. Any more questions from others? I hope all of you fill the form. If anybody not to fill the form, can all of you please fill that form? anybody.
One last question. Okay, so normally, like, let's say when we are comparing this full stack world versus data science world, so does data science require high intelligence or high mathematical and statistical capability?
Yes, definitely. Like, you see the course content of the data science, they are going to make you some algebra, data, like a statistics, and these kind of things they are going to teach you. But I don't think that much knowledge is required on that one. So if you are good in Python, yes, that's fair enough with the models, whatever the machine learning models, and some advanced concepts inside the Python, that is fair enough to become a and also you should know the pattern of the data. You should have some prior knowledge, domain knowledge also is very important to become a data scientist. I don't see like you need much probability or statistics. This knowledge is required much. Go ahead, next question.